Hello, and welcome to the Gritit mid-season training video. Please pay close attention to the matters that we are about to address, as they contain important information regarding both training and safety issues. At the conclusion of this video, you will be required to complete a short test regarding the content. Using your PDA. The Tillogis Work Plan is a free app which can be downloaded from either the Android Play Store or the Apple App Store. When you click on the Tillogis app, you will need to provide your username and password in the exact format that it was provided to you. It is case sensitive, and your username must have the colon, which are the two vertical dots, before the start of your name. Once you have logged in, the first screen that will appear is the pre-DVIR, which stands for the Driver's Vehicle Inspection Record. The first thing to check here is that the vehicle's registration number shown on the top left of your page matches the vehicle that you are currently driving. If this does not match your vehicle, you must contact your line manager immediately, as this will need to be remedied prior to you commencing work. Next, select your region and then commence the required vehicle checks. Please note, this is not a living room activity. We need you to physically perform these checks each day. It is for your benefit, so as to minimize any potential delays whilst you are out servicing your sites. Once you've completed the vehicle checklist, you will need to confirm whether or not there is any damage to your vehicle, and also confirm the vehicle mileage. This needs to be accurate so that we can monitor the vehicle's use and have regard to any service requirements. You will then be required to confirm that you are fit for work and that you are not carrying any unauthorized passengers. Once you have submitted the vehicle checklist, you will need to click on the jobs icon on the main Tillogis screen. This will provide you with a list of all jobs that you will need to service during that particular shift. However, you will see that the first job that is listed is called start route, and that the last job that is listed is called end route. These are important, as they effectively notify our system when to expect activity on your sites. Prior to leaving home, you will need to select the start route and then select en route, followed by the on-site icons. You will then need to scroll down the page to the required gritting form and confirm the relevant declaration. You can then click on the completed icon. You can then select your first job and select en route. Once you have arrived on site, you should then click the on-site icon and commence the servicing of that site. Once you have completed all areas of the site, you will then need to scroll down the page again and complete the gritting job form. This provides both ourselves and our clients an accurate synopsis of the conditions on site, both prior to and post service. You can then confirm that all areas have been completed, along with confirmation of any water pooling on site. The general comments section provides you with an area to note anything of concern to you. Was an outside tap left running? A gate open, or anything else that you feel both ourselves and the client should know about. In the case of something serious, you should always contact your line manager in any event. With a few exceptions, your site should contain a QR code, which has been strategically placed for your convenience. If you are unsure and cannot locate a QR code for any particular site, please contact your line manager for further advice. When you click on the QR icon on your PDA, your camera facility will automatically open, and you will need to allow the camera to focus on the code to complete its scan. Next, you will need to click on the QR GPS icon, which will then allow the coordinates to be recorded accurately. By pressing on the submit button, you will then be able to click on the completed icon and repeat the same process for your next job. Once all of your physical jobs have been completed, you will then need to click on the end job icon. Please complete the end job before leaving your final site and submit it on your PDA as normal. Finally, and this is very important, you must remember to log off the Tillogis work plan at the conclusion of each shift. We recommend that you do this when you have arrived at home, as this will allow enough time for all of your completed jobs to upload to our system correctly. Access issues. If you arrive at any of your sites and experience any kind of access issue, you must immediately report this to your line manager by telephone. There are many scenarios where this may occur, including a new padlock being fitted, security staff being unavailable, and a large array of other reasons. It may be that you are refused entry by the site security or other members of staff, and in that instance you must obtain their details prior to reporting the issue to your line manager by telephone. Remember though, you must be polite and professional at all times. In the case where your vehicle cannot enter, and yet you can still access the site on foot, please immediately contact your line manager and he or she will guide you on which areas to service by hand. Gritting plans. When attending any site, you must have a copy of the site plan with you, either physically or in electronic format on your PDA. The site plan shows you clearly all of the areas that require servicing. This is everywhere inside the yellow coloured borders. The plan also shows you all of the areas that will require pedestrian snow clearance should the need arise. These areas are also clearly marked with the dark blue coloured lines. The lighter blue shaded areas are for the mechanical snow clearance vehicles that will attend site if required. If you notice any areas on the site that do not match the site service plan, please notify your line manager accordingly. With regard to any pedestrian snow clearance, please remember that this is required where there is a 2 cm accumulation of snow or more. Using the pedestrian plough provided, you will need to clear the relevant areas prior to gritting. Please do not forget to report this on your PDA job questionnaire when completing the job. Salt application. There are 3 levels of salt application that can be put down according to the conditions at the time of service. These are low, medium, or high. A low application equates to 15 grams per square meter, a medium is 30 grams per square meter, and a high application is 40 grams per square meter. If you have any questions regarding the level of application required, please contact your line manager. Your line manager will also guide you on the required levels of application for each day of service. Pedestrian spreading or gritting by hand. There are 2 ways that this can be achieved, either by the use of a pedestrian spreader or by using a bucket and scoop. In the case of a pedestrian spreader, please remember that the lever at the back of the spreader will allow you to control the flow of salt. If using a bucket and scoop, there are 2 methods of application depending on the type of area being covered. If the area is quite wide and with no vegetation, we suggest a sweeping action across your body towards your bucket arm. However, in the case of a narrow pathway, you will need to use the underarm bowling technique to achieve the desired spread. This is particularly important where there is vegetation or landscaping present. Whether it is pedestrian spreading or by vehicle, great care needs to be taken when applying salt to surrounding areas near to vegetation. Salt will kill grass, plants, and flowers. It is therefore very important that you exercise great care when applying it to such areas. Equally, it is also important that care is taken when applying salt to doorways and window areas. Use your own initiative, but it is easy to accumulate unsightly clumps of salt in such areas. Please take your time and apply to these areas with great care. General information. Start times. With the exception of rail stations and prisons, we can only service our sites between 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. That means that you cannot arrive on your first site before that time. If you arrive before this, you will trigger an early activation notification on our system, and you will almost certainly be required to re-attend that site and complete an additional gritting form on your PDA. We recommend that you do not approach your first site until at least 3 minutes past your start time. Please note that this only applies to your first site of the evening. Vehicle loads. Given the various types of vehicles and spreaders being used throughout the company, it is your responsibility to ensure that you do not overload your vehicle. Please check your maximum weight loads on page 5 of your operator's manual. This is a legal requirement and it is your responsibility. Vehicle speeds. Please remember that when towing a trailer or carrying a load, your maximum speed should always be 10 miles per hour under the speed limit for the road that you are on. This does not apply to you if you are driving in a 30 mile per hour zone or under. Shotguns. If you take an assistant with you, he or she must be at least 18 years old. All operators and assistants must be registered on our system and they must carry an ID card with them at all times. Rail stations and rail safety. When servicing rail stations, you must be wearing an orange high-vis vest or jacket along with your regular PPE, including safety boots. Remember, yellow high-vis are for regular sites, whilst orange high-vis is for rail stations. Servicing times. Whilst we normally operate and service sites between 6 p.m. and 6 a.m, there are some exceptions, including prisons and rail stations. You can commence servicing rail stations from 1601. However, you cannot approach those sites before that specified time. This includes parking immediately outside or close to the station. All sites, including rail stations, are encircled with an electronic geofence. When entering that geofence, you will activate your site automatically, and doing this prior to the required time will generate an early service notification on our system. This will cause the job to become invalid, and you will be required to re-attend and complete an additional gritting form. We recommend that you do not approach anywhere in the vicinity of your first rail station before 3 minutes past 4 p.m. Rail station service plans and service areas. Unlike the service plans that you use on your regular sites, some of the plans for the rail stations may be ordnance survey plans that the client has provided directly. In that case, the areas to service are clearly marked in blue, and you must therefore ensure that all areas within the blue boundary lines are serviced. Snow clearance on platforms and car parks. If you encounter any snow on a rail platform, it must be cleared before any gritting takes place. There is no minimum accumulation of snow before clearance is required on a rail platform. The rule is that any snow must be cleared. When clearing snow from a platform, the snow must be pushed back away from the edge to a minimum distance of 1.5 meters. Under no circumstances should snow be pushed over the edge of a platform. This could have severe and dangerous consequences. When clearing snow from rail station car parks, all areas must be cleared, including any and all walkways. Access issues. Rail stations are no different from any other site that you may service. If there are any areas within your service plan that you cannot access for any reason, you must call your line manager and or your night office to report that access issue. You must do this on each and every occasion that you encounter an access issue, even if you've reported it previously. Rail station summary. When servicing rail stations, please remember, always wear the correct clothing and PPE. Never approach a site before 1601. Follow your service plan. Clear any snow away from the edge of a platform to a minimum distance of 1.5 meters. Clear 100% of snow away from the car parks and walkways, and always report any access issues. In respect of your rail station start times, you must always adhere to the start times provided by your line manager on a daily basis. This will incorporate the consideration of any adverse weather conditions such as rain and snow, and may require a later start time than 1601 in any event. This is also applicable to your initial start times on any of your other sites. Operator's manual. Just like the site plan, it is essential and mandatory that you carry your operator's manual with you when attending any sites. This can be in physical form or in electronic form on your PDA. It contains essential information that you will require in many circumstances that can frequently occur. If you do not have an operator's manual, please contact your line manager and request one as soon as possible. Gritit uniform. All operators, including shotguns, are required to wear the standard Gritit uniform, which incorporates dark coloured pants or jeans, a dark coloured shirt, a Gritit fleece, and a Gritit high-vis vest. You must also wear or have with you your Gritit ID card. If you require any of the above items, please contact your line manager. PPE and machinery. Always remember safety first. Please don't take any chances. You have been provided with gloves, safety glasses, and dust masks. These are for your own protection, so please use them accordingly. One of the most frustrating scenarios for any operator relates to the breakdown of equipment. Whilst we will do everything within our power to get you operational again as quickly as possible, it is worth remembering that such circumstances may have been avoided with proper and regular maintenance checks. Let's look at a few of the most common problems. Greasing points. There are greasing points on both the Snow-X and Veil spreaders, and you have been provided with a greasing gun and grease. Applying 2 squirts of grease to the greasing points on your trailer should be undertaken at least once every month. If you are unsure where those greasing points are on your trailer, please ask your line manager at the earliest opportunity. Tow bars and tow balls. These are two separate things. The tow bar is what the tow ball is connected to, and it has a tendency to crack and corrode over time and usage. You will need to check this on a daily basis and report any concerns to your line manager. Your tow ball must also be checked on a daily basis for any cracks and to ensure that the connecting bolts are tight and secure. The bolts have a tendency to work loose, and this could cause serious damage to both life and property. You should carry at least 2 spare tow bar bolts with you at all times. If you are unsure about the size and the strength required, please contact your line manager. Snow-X 8500. On the Snow-X 8500s, there have been numerous reports that the brakes can stick. This is easy to rectify, and you should speak to your line manager about how and when to check for the correct settings. There can also be structural problems that are easily detectable on the 8500s. If you notice any bulging on the side of the Snow-X, this could be a telltale sign that the V-plate inside is broken. You should always check that the bolts are secure and tight whenever your Snow-X is empty. Veils. On the veils, there can often be hydraulic hose problems. Please check your hoses frequently and report any cracks or deterioration to your line manager. In addition, please make sure that you always carry a spill kit with you and use this in case of any loss of hydraulic fluid. There now follows a short video on the correct procedure when using a spill kit. If you do not operate a veil or equipment that uses hydraulic fluid, you can now skip this video by moving your slider bar at the bottom of your screen until the spill kit video has concluded. If you are going to skip the spill kit video, the next subject to watch is titled Clean and Tidy Vehicles. Otherwise, please pay close attention to this short video.
When we develop spill plans for sites, these are based on stop, contain, and notify. If there is a spill, stop work immediately if it is safe to do so. Identify the source of pollution and prevent any more material spilling. Next, contain the spillage immediately, such as with buns of earth, sandbags, and drip trays. Contain it so it doesn't enter any watercourses or leave site. As we can see here, the operative is using a drain cover to seal the drain and stop any of the spilled material entering the surface water drainage system. Next, a temporary bund is created around the drainage site to stop any material entering the drain even further. The drainage pads may already stop this, but the extra protection will help. Next, I'm wearing the correct PPE. Absorb the spillage with the correct material. When a spill has taken place, you need to notify your supervisor or site manager, giving the following information. Firstly, whether the material has entered any drains or is affecting the environment, such as wildlife. Next, you need to tell them the material involved, the location of the spill, the reason for the incident, and the quantity of spill material escaped. Contaminated spill materials should be bagged up securely and placed in a container for disposal of hazardous waste and meet all waste duty of care regulations. When planning for spill prevention or any other foreseen environmental emergency, the Environment Agency in England and Wales, Scottish Environment Protection Agency and the Northern Ireland Environment Agency publish a series of pollution prevention guidelines. These are an excellent source of information and are highly recommended.
Clean and tidy vehicles. Please clean your vehicles both inside and out on a regular basis. Our image is important to us, and a clean vehicle will reflect a positive impression on both existing and potential clients. Vehicle and equipment cleanouts. When required by your line manager, you will need to remove all salt from your vehicle and spreader. This must be done in conjunction with the relevant form on your PDA. Log into the Telogis app on your PDA and click on Forms. You will need to scroll down to the form titled Vehicle and Equipment Cleanout. Select your region and enter your vehicle registration. Please take all relevant photographs according to the subject matter and confirm that all salt has been removed. Submit the form and then you can log out of the Telogis app. The cleanout is for your own benefit. Your line manager will attempt to notify you in advance of any proposed cleanout so that you can finish with a minimum load prior to that required cleanout. Control box errors. Primarily, there are four errors that can occur on the Snowex control boxes, and they will stop you from servicing your sites until the problem is resolved. If you receive the error code EO, it means that there is a disruption in the electronic circuit. This could be a very simple problem to resolve, and you will need to check all plugs and ensure that all connections are waterproofed by using Vaseline or something similar. The E1 error code confirms that your control box is faulty and you will need to ring your line manager to arrange an immediate replacement. The LB error code indicates a low battery, and again you should immediately telephone your line manager for advice. The AR error code indicates that something is sticking and causing your auger to malfunction. You will need to clear any blockage before you can continue servicing. The AR error code is likely to occur if you have overloaded your trailer. Vehicle breakdowns. In case of vehicle breakdowns, including problems with tyres, please refer to your operator's manual to obtain the Run Your Fleet telephone numbers. Please inform your line manager immediately with regard to breakdowns or any other vehicle problems. Snow chains. There now follows a short video on the correct procedure on how to fit snow chains. If you do not use snow chains, you can now skip this video by moving your slider bar until the video has concluded. If skipping this video, the next subject to watch is titled Personal Details and Responsibilities. Otherwise, please pay close attention to the following video. Thank you. personal details and responsibilities. If any of your personal details change, you are required to inform your line manager as soon as you are able. This includes your address, telephone number, or bank details. Such notification must be via email so that there is an accurate record of any such changes. Periodically, you will receive texts and emails from your line manager regarding various issues. Please attempt to respond to these as quickly as possible, but when doing so, please reply to the message itself rather than sending a completely new message. This allows a trail to be created and saves any confusion. Phones and PDAs. It is important that your phones or PDAs are kept fully charged and turned on with the audio unmuted. Your line manager will only call you after you have concluded your shift in an urgent situation regarding one of your sites. This will be an important and very pressing matter, and we need you to answer the phone if such a situation occurs. Fuel cards. Please examine your fuel card and note the expiry date. If it will expire before the season concludes, please inform your line manager so that he or she can order a replacement. Whenever you've placed fuel into your vehicle, it is a mandatory requirement that you provide the correct mileage at the till on every occasion. Please remember that fuel cards and vehicles are for business use only. Shotguns. This is the Gritit terminology used for those people assisting you in the servicing of sites. For those who do not currently use shotguns, please speak to your line manager regarding obtaining shotguns for pedestrian snow clearance purposes. Salt requirements. Each of you will use various salt yards during the course of your shifts. It is your responsibility to keep an eye on the levels of salt at each yard that you use. If you become concerned about the level of salt stock available at any particular yard, please notify your line manager so that more salt can be ordered. Please do not leave this in hope that another operator will do it. Contact your line manager as soon as you become concerned. It is also important that the salt is properly covered. Please ensure that you load your salt from the bottom of the pile and that the covering is replaced properly using the sandbags or other weights that are available. Please report any damaged or torn coverings to your line manager. To lodgers. Occasionally, you may have difficulty logging into the To Lodgers work plan app on your PDA. In such circumstances, you should delete the app and reinstall it by referring to your operator's manual. If the problem persists and remains unresolved, please contact your line manager for advice. Working alone. Please note our health and safety guidance about working alone in conjunction with the Health and Safety at Work Act 1974 and the Management of Health and Safety at Work Regulations 1999. All workers have responsibilities to take reasonable care of themselves and other people affected by their work activities and to cooperate with their employers in meeting their legal obligations. Gritit operators working alone are considered lone workers, and as such, Gritit completes risk assessments and method statements for each site on an annual basis. A sample of the risk assessment can be found within your operator's manual. By law, we must address health and safety matters with you. Effective consultation helps to ensure that relevant hazards are identified and appropriate and proportionate control measures are chosen. This is why we always address such matters in the start of season training and the mid-season training, along with the reporting systems used while performing winter maintenance. We believe that there are 7 important questions that must be answered. Question 1. Can one person adequately control the risks of the job? This is established on the dry run and the site surveys that we conduct prior to offering you the site. Question 2. Can one person operate the machinery safely? All machinery is covered with the operators at the start of the season training. Question 3. Am I at risk from chemicals or hazardous substances? Personal protection equipment is provided by the company, and this includes goggles, gloves, and dust masks. Again, this is addressed in the start of season and the mid-season training. Question 4. If the lone worker's first language is not English, are suitable arrangements in place to ensure clear communications, especially in an emergency? All Gritit operators are vetted before being engaged to carry out winter maintenance, and one of the requirements is to be able to read, write, and speak English to a competent level. Question 5. Why is training so important? Safe practice is highlighted during the start of season training, and this includes manual handling, speed limits, using the flashing beacon whilst gritting, and wearing the correct PPE. Question 6. How would the person be supervised and monitored? Supervision is conducted by regular site inspections, monitoring the tracking of the vehicle via the operational management team, along with near-miss reporting. Each operator must have a phone or PDA to access the company technology. Question 7. What happens if a person becomes ill, has an accident, or there is an emergency? All operators are provided with a first aid kit, which must be in their vehicles at all times. Operators must have direct access to their line managers at all times, have ready access to a PDA or phone, and report any such issues on their job completion report. We also constantly monitor each operator via a comprehensive vehicle tracking system. In summary, please request additional training if you are unsure of anything. Please ensure that you use the pre-issued PPE. Please use your beacon while on site. Please make sure your phone is charged at all times and that you are contactable. Please make sure that your line manager is aware if you are going to be uncontactable for any period of time. And please remember to report any near misses, on-site precautions and actions. It is important that you always lock your vehicle whenever you exit. Equally, make sure that any equipment is secured when not in use. Never leave equipment unattended on site, secure it in your vehicle or by the use of a chain and padlock. Be vigilant and don't take any chances. Under no circumstances should you ever give chase to a thief. If it becomes possible, try to obtain a photograph or video of the situation, but only if it is safe to do so. If there is another vehicle involved, try to obtain the registration number and write it down as quickly as possible. Again, only do so if it does not place you in danger. Try to obtain a good description of the individual or individuals involved, and again, try to write this down as quickly as possible so that you don't forget any important factors. Call the police immediately and give them as much information as you can while it is still fresh in your mind. Finally, call your line manager and he or she will advise you on the next course of action. Servicing your sites. Just a quick reminder of some of the basic issues. Bucket and scoop. When walking down a narrow pathway, the most effective method is to use the underarm bowling technique. This will allow you to control the width, length, and the amount of salt being applied. Let's take another look. On the majority of sites, you are going to find areas that will not accommodate the pedestrian spreader, and neither will it be suitable to use the technique with the bucket and scoop that you have just seen. In this situation, you should use a widespread action from across your chest and towards your bucket arm. We cannot stress enough the importance of correctly servicing your site. Every pathway and area within the yellow boundaries of your site plan requires full and proper applications. If you fail to service an area, or fail to service an area correctly, you are playing with the safety of every person who may visit that site. Please do not rush the servicing of any site for any reason whatsoever. Take your time and ensure that all areas are properly covered. That way, the client and the public will see and know that they are safe and that they are in excellent hands with Gritit. This concludes the mid-season training video. We hope that it has been of some benefit to you and that you now have a clearer understanding of all procedures and requirements. Please continue to remain safe during the remainder of the season and do not hesitate to contact your line managers with regard to any questions that you may have. Thank you for watching this video and for the excellent professional service that you have so far provided.